MyBeds.ie, Ireland's leading online bed and mattress retailer. You'll get a luxury Irish bed mattress, upholstered base and headboard from an amazing €229. Check out the full range at DFIBeds.ie. Delivery is free and guaranteed to be with you within 5 working days.
New COVID-19 cases and 25 deaths. 233 of those cases are in County Dublin, 37 in Kildare, 30 in Meath, 25 in Donegal and 24 in Westmeath. 489 people are in hospital with the illness, with 114 in ICU. The country's 14-day incidence rate now stands at 199 cases per 100,000 people, the first time it has gone below 200 this year. Elsewhere, Foreign Affairs Minister Simon Coveney has accused the British government of undermining a commitment to the proper implementation of the North's protocol. It's after the UK extended the grace period for post-Brexit supermarket agri-food movements from the rest of the UK to Northern Ireland. Northern Ireland Secretary Brandon Lewis says certification requirements will then be introduced in phases alongside the rollout of a digital assistance scheme. Aon Connolly of the Northern Ireland Retail Consortium welcomes the news.
We have to welcome this extension of the grace periods in both time and scope, even if it is done unilaterally. We need this to allow us to continue to give Northern Ireland households choice and affordability they need. That gives us short-term stability, but there is still much to be delivered, and we cannot use this as just can-kicking. We need to find those solutions.
The University of Limerick has launched an investigation to identify which students took part in last night's street party in Castletroy. Three people were arrested and Gardaí issued over 50 fines for breaches of the Health Act. In a statement, the university says any student found to have attended the gathering will face suspension pending a full investigation or possible expulsion. Minister for Higher Education Simon Harris says the students' actions are indefensible.
This is an attack on our national effort. I mean, anybody who goes out and breaks public health rules is actually trying to set us back as a country. I mean, it is utterly indefensible. But let me be very clear. This has been taken extremely seriously by the Gardaí.
The Taoiseach has rejected concerns about the CETA trade deal, which are causing friction in the Green Party. TD Patrick Costello has taken a personal case in the High Court to question whether the Dáil has power to approve the controversial deal. He believes it may need to go to a full referendum to be taken out of the hands of TDs. Taoiseach Micheál Martin believes the concerns about companies being able to sue the state over policy decisions don't stand up.
From the legal advice I have received in relation to this and in the clarification of the European Court of Justice, that the claims that have been made against CETA in terms of the investor court are not sustainable, and that there's been very clear clarification brought by the European Court on this issue.
The Education Minister says there's no plans to introduce mass testing for schools as part of this month's reopening. Norma Foley is updating the Dáil on the phased return of in-class teaching. A number of TDs have raised concerns that some students won't be back in the classroom for over a month. Elsewhere, the Garda Commissioner has committed to pushing for Gardaí to be moved up the vaccine priority list following Saturday's anti-lockdown protests in Dublin. Drew Harris met with representatives from both the GRA and AGSI today. The GRA claims its members were spat at, had bottles of urine thrown at them and were forced into close physical altercations during the demos. President Frank Thornton says Gardaí are too far down the vaccine priority list.
We will be hoping that the Commissioner will take all concerns that we have continued